So the example we just saw, using CSmith to test C compilers, represented several years of work by my group. It was really, really sort of a large effort for us. So what I want to show now is a different example of random testing. We're going to test a tiny Unix utility function using a very tiny random tester. And so if you remember, a couple of units ago, we talked about the Unix read system call. So let's look at how the read system call works. Before I get going into this example, I should apologize a bit for dropping into C here. I tried to work this example into Python, and it really just didn't come out right. It just didn't feel right. This is sort of inherently a C example. So it's not gonna matter if you don't know C or if you don't like C. I'll go through the code, and really it will be rather simple. So the Unix read system call, as called from a C program, takes three arguments. It takes FD, which is a file descriptor. It takes buff, which is a pointer to a block of memory into which data is going to be read. And it takes a number of bytes to read from the file represented by the file descriptor into the memory block pointed to by buff. And now usually what the read system call does is it reads the number of bytes that you expected into the memory block that you provided, and all is good. So the return value of read is going to be the number of bytes read. So that's what usually happens. But there are a couple of other things that can happen. A second possibility is the read system call can return 0, indicating that you've reached the end of the file. Another thing that can happen is it can return -1 if it failed. But the fourth possibility, and this is the one that's sort of pernicious, and it's one that a lot of programmers get wrong, is that read can return a number of bytes less than the number you asked for, and this isn't a failure. This doesn't represent any sort of out of memory condition or end of file or anything like that. It just means you need to try again. And so the little Unix utility function that I'm gonna test here is a different version of read. It's a version of read called readAll that acts just like read, except that it's not gonna have this property of returning partial reads ever. So what readAll is gonna do is, in the case of a partial read, it's going to just issue another read call that picks up where the first call left off, and it's gonna repeatedly do that until the read is complete or until some sort of an error or end of file condition occurs. So if anything bad happens, we'll just return a -1 value, which is the sort of standard Unix error value. If the read calls are succeeding but returning partial results, we're just going to keep issuing read calls until we're finished. So let's look at the code that does this.